Hey, what's up, everybody? It's John from Metal Sucks, and this week on Metal Reacts Only, we're going to listen to the new Whitechapel song. It's called Hickory Creek, and it is a single from their new album coming out March 29th called The Valley. So the interesting thing about this upcoming album is that it's going to be largely about Phil Bozeman, the lead singer of the band, his upbringing in Hardin Valley, Tennessee. It sounds to me like it's going to be very personal and a little different from anything Whitechapel has ever done before. So I'm really excited to hear how these personal stories influence the music. And to be very honest, to be frank, I'm not a huge Whitechapel fan. I just haven't really listened to them that much. I think I've tried to get into them in the past, but I guess it just didn't click for me yet. Maybe this could be the song that gets me into them, and then I can backtrack to their other catalog. We shall see. But I have seen them live once before, and I do have a general idea of their sound, so I'm pretty sure I can pick up anything drastically different that comes up, hopefully. So essentially, I'm no expert on them or anything, but I'm excited to dive in and check them out and see what it's all about. So let's get on in there. This one's called Hickory Creek by Whitechapel off their new album, The Valley. Yeah, so the music already is a little softer and a little like more slower of a pace than I remember hearing from them. Oh boy, wow. Oh man, this is so sad already. Wow, okay. I don't think I've ever heard Cleans from them before. Maybe they did it recently on some of their more recent albums, but I haven't heard it, I don't think. I'm assuming that's Phil over there, yeah. And also the vocals are great here. I think these Cleans are pretty spectacular. Wow. So yeah, this definitely is about his youth. Really tough upbringing, it looks like. I mean, his mom passed away in a car accident, it looks like, and now he's living with this other woman. Jeez, man. This is some heavy stuff. Not like heavy, like music heavy, but like heavy, heavy stuff. Jeez. Now that you don't have eyes, maybe now you'll realize within your own head you're creating these lies. And the song is really good so far. It's very emotional. Jeez. Yeah, this chorus is pretty awesome. The guitars go so deep on this chorus, and like so guttural with the guitar tones. They're very crisp, very nice. You know what it kind of sounds like? I was thinking about this. It kind of sounds like the Contortionist a little bit. With what they're doing right now. It's very contortionist-y, I feel like. It gives me that kind of vibe. I'm so happy that I'm watching the music video for this. It gives so much context behind the song, and it's so well done. The acting is incredible on this. Jeez. Oh, really cool. That solo section was very good. Just the right amount of just the right amount of screaming too in this song. Like, I feel like it came out a little bit, but it's supposed to be clean, which I think is very justified for this kind of song. Yeah, and the acoustic guitars in this song are very, very well done. Well produced, they fit in so nicely with everything. Wow. Jeez. Wow, holy shit. Damn. Oh man, of his mom, that's crazy. Wow. Okay. Yeah. All right. That was That was a real ride. That was super emotional. Very well done. The cleans were phenomenal. Phil Bozeman's cleans were very good. I've never heard them before. Maybe they did it on one of their most recent albums or something. But this was really something else. I think that the emotions were beautifully encapsulated by the music. I think that the imagery certainly helped me understand what was going on with the lyrics and everything. The lyrics are beautifully written, very poetic. There's no way that you're gonna hear me saying anything bad about this song. I thought it was fantastic. I thought they did everything so well. I thought it was incredibly produced. The acoustic guitars sounded amazing. The electric guitars sounded guttural and low and fantastic, which really nicely juxtaposed the vocals and the singing and kind of the emotional sadness of the scenario. And also, of course, the video was super well done and the story was easily communicated, and it just looked great. It looked and sounded wonderful, and I think that I'm very, very excited to see what else they can release. They probably won't release any other singles since it comes out in like a few days, I guess, on the 29th, but I'm very looking forward to this new album, and I'm gonna check it out, and then after I do that, I think I'm gonna go back to their catalog and look at some of their other songs, their discography, because they definitely jumped out to me, and I'm pretty now deeply convinced that they're not just any deathcore band. So I'd love to know what you think. Did you really enjoy the song? Are you kind of like me, where you don't know much Whitechapel, and you heard the song and you were like, wow, that's actually very good? Or if you're a big fan of Whitechapel, do you like the direction they're moving in with their sound and like changing it up a bit and adding those clean vocals in? Either way, thank you so much for watching, everybody, and stay metal, my friends.